Halifax.
Monsieur le Président.
Mr. Speaker, the minister's explanations to justify cuts to the ozone monitoring budget do not hold water. The minister claims that cutbacks are needed to better monitor tar sands pollution. The Conservatives are telling us that we have to sacrifice the ozone layer to better understand pollution in the oil sands. Cutbacks will have an impact on the quality of our environment. Why are the Conservatives not telling Canadians the truth? The Honourable Minister of the Environment.
Let me say again, Environment Canada will continue to monitor the ozone. The World Ozone and Ultraviolet Data Centre will continue to deliver world-class services. And our government will continue to protect the environment in the most cost-effective ways possible.
Mr. Speaker, the minister continues to insist that the cuts to the ozone monitoring programs are harmless, and he makes it sound so simple. We have two ozone measurements, and now we're just going to have one. But he's disregarding the science because, Mr. Speaker, they measure different things. Because of the minister's short-sightedness, now we're not going to have the data that we need to track the hole in the ozone layer. So why is the minister disregarding both science and common sense?
Well, Mr. Speaker, my colleague has misquoted me, but I will assure her that the environment remains a key priority for this government, even at times of fiscal restraint. As we are doing across all of government, we will be taking a close look at all of our spending over the next year, and the results of our deficit reduction action plan will be announced in the budget next spring.
The Honourable Member for Rivière-du-Nil.
Keystone Pipeline is another example of this government's failed economic and environmental policies. The pace of development in the oil sands means that this government won't even meet its own climate change targets. Mr. Speaker, will the minister explain why the government keeps stubbornly promoting this pipeline instead of defending the best interests of Canadians?
Good question.
Well, Mr. Speaker, the Keystone XL pipeline is going to provide a substantial economic benefit to both Canada and the United States. We trade oil, natural gas, electricity across our borders every day. While the opposition continues to bash Canada abroad, our government will defend the Canadian economy, will defend Canadian resources, and will defend the 600,000 plus Canadian jobs that we've created since the recession started.
The Honourable Member for Rivière-du-Midil. Mr. Speaker, the Minister talks about economic development. Let's talk about jobs. Workers in the region have been very clear the pipeline will drain thousands of good jobs from Canada. Mr. Speaker, why is the government prepared to sell off our jobs and our environment?
Well, Mr. Speaker, the NDP talking about jobs in the oil sands is ridiculous. Their environment critic has called for a moratorium on oil sands development that would kill thousands, tens of thousands of Canadian jobs. We know that there's over 100,000 Canadian jobs that are tied to the oil sands. They want to stop every last one of them, so they are willing to sacrifice good Canadian jobs. We're not willing to do that. We're going to stand up and defend Canadians.
The Honourable Member for 12.